माय चैनल आई एम अनामिका। होली इज़ राउंड द कॉर्नर एंड इट्स अ फेस्टिवल ऑफ कलर्स, जॉय एंड हैप्पीनेस। आई माई सेल्फ लव प्लेइंग होली एंड मोस्ट ऑफ अस डू, बट एट द सेम टाइम वी आर स्कैर्ड ऑफ गेटिंग एक्सपोज टू दोज केमिकल बेस्ड कलर्स, ऑफ गेटिंग रैशेज, एलर्जीज, इरीटेशंस पोस्ट होली। सो आई एम हेयर टू टेल यू वॉट यू नीड टू डू बिफोर होली एंड पोस्ट होली टू अवॉइड दोज यू नो हार्मफुल इफेक्ट्स ऑफ होली and you can enjoy your festival without any worries. So first I'm going to tell you what you need to do pre-Holi. Always try to use organic gulal or colors, so they will not be harmful on your skin. Don't use those stubborn dark colors, because they take lot of time to remove from your skin and at the same time they harm your skin maximum. Please do moisturize your skin. I know many of us have heard that, you know, our grandmother and mothers, they tell us please apply oil before leaving house. But you know, it's a new generation and everyone takes selfie. So oil just tends to give you dull and shiny effect on your selfie. So it's better to apply a moisturizer instead of oil. Even you can use a primer, because it fills into our pores and it acts as a protective layer between our skin and all those external things. So primer is a good option, and for those who are makeup lovers, they can go for a light coverage foundation. In this way you are creating a base so that the colors will not directly gonna affect on your skin. And now the most important step is using a sunscreen, because in Holi we just expose ourselves directly under the sun, and so it's very important to protect your skin by using a good sunblock. And my suggestion is to use a Neutrogena Ultra Sheer SPF 50 plus, and it has a PA triple plus also, so you can go for it. In this way you just not going to be tanned after Holi. To protect your lip, you can go for a lip balm, and you can also apply some lipstick. And to protect your nails, please do apply a thick layer of nail paint. Coming to hair, don't forget to oil your hair before leaving, because oiling just protects your hair and scalp from getting exposed to colors directly, and you can apply any oil you want. If you are having long hair, you can make a bun like this, and you can even go for a side braid, or you can apply a scarf also, so you will look little bit stylish also. You can have a colorful scarf. So this is it for the pre-Holi preparation. Now I'm going to tell you what you need to do after coming back home. So first of all, you need to have a cleanser, or you can use a raw milk by adding little bit of almond or olive oil. Take a cotton swab and cleanse your face with this 2 to 3 times. Please avoid using soap or face wash on your skin. Then after that, what you need to do is take little bit of basin, add 2-3 spoons of curd plus honey also, and then apply all over your body including face, and just leave it for 15 to 20 minutes. After it get dry, just rub it and just, you know, cleanse it with a simple lukewarm water. If you feel little bit of irritation on your skin, use rose water to spray on your face, and do it for at least 2 to 3 times in a day. In this way, it's gonna just relieve your irritation and all the rashes if you have. Your hair, on the first wash, please only use shampoo, don't apply conditioner. And on the second wash, you can apply conditioner also. If you are feeling dryness and itchiness on your scalp and your face, you can make a simple home pack, which is a super nourishing one. Take one banana and just mash it, add little bit of honey plus turmeric, and you can add raw milk and apply all over your scalp till your entire length, and on your face also leave it for few minutes and then wash it off. You need to do it for 1 to 2 days to get your normal skin back. So that's all from my side. I hope you like this video, and please do follow these small tips and make your festival healthier and safer. Enjoy this Holi, and also share this video with all your near and dear ones, so they can also stay safer and look beautiful.